गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, दिस इज नागुल मीरा। आवर सब्जेक्ट इज पीपीएससी फॉर फर्स्ट सिविल। इन दैट सेकंड यूनिट इनिशियलाइजेशन एंड अपडेटिंग, दैट इज आवर टॉपिक टुडेस। आवर टॉपिक इज इनिशियलाइजेशन एंड अपडेटिंग। ओके ना, हियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इनिशियलाइजेशन? व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इनिशियलाइजेशन? हियर इनिशियलाइजेशन इज नथिंग बट assign some value to the particular variable. Okay, na? In this initialization process, what we have to do here, assign some value to that particular variable. To assign some value to that particular variable in our C programming language, first we must declare that particular variable. Okay, na? Without declare a variable, we can't assign some value. Okay, na? So if we want to initialize some value to that particular variable, we first define or we first declare the variable first. Okay, na? So how do you declare a variable in our C programming language? Here a simple syntax is there. Okay, na? So this simple syntax shows how to declare a variable. Okay, na? If we want to use or if we want to initialize or if we want to update something, any, okay, na? If we want to use that particular variable in our programming language, we first declare. Without declaration, we can't use that particular variable. If we use without declaration, our program says that is error. Okay, na? Declaration error. System says that is a declaration error. Okay, na? Here the declaration error is nothing but variable is used in the program, but that variable is not declared. Okay, na? That variable is not declared. That is the meaning of that particular error. Okay, na? If our program shows declaration error, variable declaration error, or something unknown variable, that means that variable is used in our program but without declaration. That means if we want to use or if we want to initialize or if we want to update a variable in the program, we first declare that particular variable. Okay, now after declaration we can use, we can initialize or we can update, we can do anything. Okay, now we can do anything with that particular variable. So first declare that particular variable before we use in the programming language. Not only C, in C++, Java also. Okay, na? First declare and then use. Okay, na? So that is the meaning of declaration. Okay, na? Here how a variable is declared in our C or C++ or any something Java language. Here the simple syntax is there. Okay, na? data type space variable name, data type space variable name, semicolon. Okay, na? This syntax shows single variable declaration at a time. Okay, na? Here there is another syntax is there. Here data type space variable 1 space variable 2 space up to a variable. Okay, na? Not space here, comma. Okay, na? Data type space variable 1 comma variable 2 comma variable 3 comma up to variable n. Okay, na? Last semicolon. Okay, na? So data type space variable 1 comma variable 2 comma up to variable n, last one semicolon. So this syntax shows we can declare multiple number of variables at a time. This syntax shows single variable declaration. Okay, na? Then so this is a simple syntax to declare a variable. Example. Okay, na? Example. Int a. Okay, na? We have already seen these particular syntaxes. Here int a. That means here a is a variable that is the type of integer. Int, that is a data type space a. That means a is a variable which type? Integer type. Float space variable. Float space variable. So this is another syntax. Okay, na? So here float is nothing but a variable. Float is nothing but a data type. Variable is nothing but something variable name, A, B, C, something, anything. Okay. So this syntax, this example is float space A comma B semicolon. What it says here, ABs are two different types of variable, which type float type. Okay. So this is a single variable declaration. This is multiple variable declarations. Okay. So this is a simple declaration of variable. Okay. So after declaration of that particular variables, we can initialize or update that value. Okay. So now coming to our next syntax, that is initialization of variable. Okay. So first we declare that particular variable, okay, now which data type, how many types of variables. After this declaration, we can initialize some value to that particular variable or variables. Okay. Na? So here initialization is nothing but assign some value to that particular variable. Okay. Na? So here equal to operator. Here is okay. Na? Equal to operator is used to assign some value to that particular variable that is already declared. Okay. Na? Here important point is equal to operator is used to assign or initialize some value to that particular already declared variable or variables. Syntax is data type variable name equal to constant or something expression or something value. Okay, na? Then here data type is optional. Why? Because if already declared variable, here data type is not necessary. If that particular variable is not declared, here data type is necessary. Okay, now data type is necessary. Now coming to our here example, int a equal to 10. In this particular example, we are declaring the variable and also we are assigning some value. Okay, now we are declaring the variable and also we are assigning some value to that particular variable. In this, two operations are done. What are those? First one, declaration. Okay, now A variable is declared, that is the type of integer. A variable is declared and then 10 value is assigned with the help of equal to operator. Okay, now. So we can write this. Okay, now. Yes. Simply we can write this. If we already declared, we can use this way. Okay, na? A equal to 10. Simply this is the initialization. A equal to 10 semicolon. So simply this is the initialization. In this, variable A is already declared. Variable A is declared already. So int A, that is a declaration. Now A equal to 10, that means initialization. Here value 10 is assigned to variable A with the help of equal to operator. We can use this way. Okay, na? So yes, we can use this way also. Yes, we can use this way also. How? A equal to B plus C. A equal to B plus C. In that A is a variable, that is the type of integer, equal to B plus C. In this B, C, A, B, C, there are three variables first declared. Okay, na? First declare cheskovalandi. Declare cheskunna tarvata what you use cheskovali. For example, here B equal to 10, C equal to 10 anukunnamandi. Okay, na? So here int A comma B comma C, that is the declaration. Now B equal to 10, C equal to 10. I am initializing some value B, C, and then here A equal to B plus C. What it done? B value is 10 plus C value is 10. B plus C, that is A equal to B plus C. That means 10 plus 10. B 10 plus C 10. 20. 20 is assigned to variable A. 20 is assigned to variable A. So, okay, now. So in this way, we can initialize the variable after declaration. Okay. So this is the simple example. Now here there is a syntax is there. in this syntax show, so multiple variable can be initialized in a single statement. Okay, na? Multiple variables can be initialized in a single statement. How? For example, A equal to B equal to C equal to D equal to E equal to 10. Okay, na? A equal to B equal to C equal to D equal to E equal to 10. What it means? So, A, B, C, D, E. First declared. Okay, na? First declared. For example, int A comma B comma C comma D comma E. So simply there are five variables. Those are A to E. That is the type of integer first declared. And then I am used A equal to B equal to C equal to D equal to E equal to 10. What it means? So what this means, 10 value is assigned to these all variables at a time. Okay, na? 10 value is assigned. 10 value is assigned to variable A, B, C, D, E at a time. That is the meaning of this one. Okay. So we can use this type also. We can use this type of also. Okay. So this is nothing but initialization of variables. Okay. So simply I am recalling again, equal to operator is assigned or initialize some value to that particular already declared variable. Now updating, that is the meaning of initialization. Now coming to our updating. First, what is the meaning of updating? Here updating is nothing but modify or something change the already initialized value. Updating is nothing but change. Update is nothing but change or something increment or decrement. Okay, now increment or decrement, something updates. Update already assigned that particular value. How we can update? Simply here. Simple, for example, A equal to 10. Simple example, this shows A equal to 10. Okay, A equal to 10. Now, B equal to 10, C equal to 10, I am initializing. Now, what is the present value of A? That is 10. Now, I am using A equal to B plus C. That means, now, what is our A's value? Before this statement, A value is 10. But after this statement, B value is 20. Why? Because A value is 20. Why? Because B value 10, C value 10, I am initialized. Now A equal to B plus C. That means 10 plus 10, 20. This 20 is assigned to A. That means previous this statement, A value is 10. Okay, after execution of this statement, A value is 20. So this value is updated. This value is updated. How updated? Okay, any programming language value can be updated depends upon that previous statement. That previous statement. Before this execution, A value is 10. After this execution, B value is 10. C value also 10. B plus C, that means 20. A equal to B plus C, that means this 20 value is assigned to A. That means A is updated. That means A is updated. Previous this statement, A value is 10. But after this statement, A value is 20. That means A value is updated. So simply we can say how values are updated. That is depends upon the previous execution. That is depends upon the just previous update. Okay, previous updation. But previous manam edaithe statement rasamo danni batti manam value anedi update avutu untundi. So this is nothing but updation of values or updation of variables. Okay, na? So this is the concept of initialization and updating. Simply if we want to update the variable, first we must declare that particular variable. After declare, then only we can initialize or we can update. Okay, na? And then simply if we want to use any variable in the program, we must declare the variable. Okay, na? So this is the meaning of initialization and updating. Now next one, break and continue statements. This is very important personally. in previous exams, most previous exams, this question is very important. Chance for the question which in the example. Okay, na? So define, break, and continue. Explain with example. 8 marks question. Okay, na? Define, break, and continue statements. Explain with example. Question using open. Okay, na? So break and continue statements. That is our topic. Okay, na? Here break and continue statements are a simple statements. Break and continue statements are a simple statements. These statements are very useful in loops. And these two statements are very useful in loops. Okay, na? Now coming to our break statement. Coming to our break statement. Break statement is a one type of statement. This statement is very useful in if conditions are something loops, any loop, do while loop or while loop or something for loop. In any loop, we can use this break statement, and also if conditions also we can use this break statement. Okay, na? What is the main purpose? Now, simply here, a break statement is a statement. This is encountered within the loop. This is encountered within the loop. Okay, na? When the break statement is executed, when the break statement is executed, okay, na? So our program execution is stopped. Our loop execution is stopped. Break. So man break statement ekkadaithe appearindo, okay, na? Ekkadaithe appearindo, mana program akkado stop aipothundi. Program execution is just immediately block or immediately stop the execution. Okay, na? This is nothing but break. This is nothing but break. So simply, when break statement is encoded within the loop, the program control immediately break out of the loop, break out of the loop, and resume execution with the statement following the loop. Ante meaning empty mana loops lo e break anedi use chesthe em avutundanta, loops lo break anedi use chesthe em avutundanta, man execution eppudaithe break statement execute ayindo mana execution akkato stop aipothundi. Okay, na? So here there is a example. This example shows how actually this break statement is executed, how this break statement is useful. Now this is a simple program. This is a simple program. Okay, na? This program name is break.c. okay, na? I am given my program name is break.c. now this is my header file, has good stdio.h file main. Okay, na? There is a one variable, that is the type of integer, that is I. Okay, now for I equal to 1, I greater than, I less than 10, I plus plus. Okay, now for I equal to 1, I less than 10, I plus plus. Okay, now start. If I equal to 5, if I equal to 5, break. Print of value of I percentage is something I close. What it program shows, simply I am explaining. Here, integer, this is defined. This is defined. That is int I. I variable is defined. Here, I variable 1 to, I variable actually start 1 to 10. Adamamiku, so I value ekkada start avalanta, okkada start avalanta, ekkada daaka vellalanta, 10 daaka vellalanta, I plus plus. I okkati increment avutu untundi. Okay, general, ee program ani execute chesthe em avutundante, generally this loop is, when this loop is executed generally without break, okay, without break, generally this break, nothing but this for is executed. Here it prints 1 to 10 numbers. Okay, na? It prints 1 to 10 numbers. Yes, equal to the value 1 to 10 numbers. Generally it prints without break. Em avutundi din execute chesthe 1 to 10 varaku print avutundi. Generally this for loop is used to print 1 to 10 numbers. Now I am using one condition here, if condition. If I equal to 5, I want to print 1 to 10 numbers. Okay, now 1 to 10 numbers. In that, if I equal to 5, when I reach 5, okay, now when I reaches 5, break avalanta. So execution 10 work allabadandi. So okati nunchi print avutu undali, 10 work print avali. This is the meaning of this. ఇక్కడ కండిషన్ రాశాను ఏంటది, ఇఫ్ ఐ ఈక్వల్ టు 5, ఎప్పుడైతే 1 టు 10 వరకు ప్రింట్ అవుతున్న సమయంలో ఐ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎప్పుడైతే 5 కి రీచ్ అయిందో బ్రేక్ రాశాను. బ్రేక్ మీన్స్ స్టాప్ ది ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ అండ్ దెన్ ప్రింట్ print those values and print those values. That means I equal to 1 printed, 2 equal to printed, 3 equal to printed, 4 equal to printed, 5. 5 means eppudaithe 5 free chaindo, if I equal to 5. Eppudaithe I value 5 free chaindo, my execution stop and then print. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 values are printed. So that is the meaning of break. So simply, what break statement is used here? Break statement is a statement which is used in loops or something if condition. When break keyword is executed in loops, it stops the execution. It stops the execution and then print the whatever statement have written. So this is the simple example. So I want to print 1 to 10 numbers, but here there is a condition I equal to 5. When my I value reaches 5, okay now, so my execution is stopped and then print those previous values. This is the simple program to demonstrate break statement. Okay, now let us execute this break.c program. Minimize. Okay now. So where is my turbo C? Yes, this is my turbo C. Okay now. So this is my program break.c. Now what here? So here I is there, clear screen. Now I equal to 1 to, okay now, I equal to 1 to I less than equal to 10. Nothing but I want to print 1 to 10. Wow. I value 1 to 10 numbers. 1 to 10 numbers, but here there is the condition if I equal to 5. When I reaches 5, break. Break. Okay now. So break the loop. Break the loop and then print those previous values. Okay now. So this is the meaning. Now what happened here? Just to compile it. Ah yes. No, not this. Okay now. Yes, it is only. Break kada man program, open that program break. Ah yes, this is my program. Now first compile it. Now I'm terminating. Yes, open turbo C. Okay now it opens. Wait just a few seconds. Yes, open. Now open, that is break.c. Yes, this is my program. Okay, now compile it. Yes, I am compiled. Now execute it. What happened here? Value of I equal to 1, value of I equal to 2, value of I equal to 3, value of I equal to 5. Okay, na? Value of I equal to 4. When value of I equal to 5, what happened? If I equal to 5, that means if I value is 5, then break the loop. Then break the loop. That means print the previous values. That is 1, 2, 4. Okay, na? If I equal to 5, so this is nothing but break. This is, so here my loop is break. If I equal to 5, then break. So I want to print only 1 to 10 values, but it prints only 1 to 4. That means if I reaches 5, then loop is break. This is nothing but break statement. So simply, how we can conclude this break statement? Okay, na? Simply, break statement is a statement. Okay, na? The main use of this break statement is when a break statement is used in our program, it break the loop. It break the loop and then print the statements. Okay, now? So this is about our break statement. Okay, now coming to our next one, that is continue statement. Continue statement. Okay. So here continue statement is another type of statement. Continue statement is a another type of statement. This is something work same as break. This is something work as break. Break in Jirgindandi, when our break statement is executed, it stops the execution of loop and then print the statements. Now here continue statement. Okay. Continue statement is a statement when it encountered in loop, all the statements after the continue statements are omitted and loop continues with the next iteration. What is the meaning of this? How I am summarizing this? Okay, so here continue statement is a statement. When the statement, nothing but continue statement, is executed, it only break the condition we have written and then continue remaining statement. Okay, so let me explain this example with practically. Okay, here this is my header file. So main int I, okay, here I variable is defined, and then for I equal to 0, I greater than, okay, na? I less than, yes, not greater than, less than, okay, na? So I less than or equal to, no, this one, okay, na? I less than or equal to 10, same program, okay, na? I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus. Now, if I equal to 5, continue, okay, na? printf value of something I percentage di. So what happened here? So simply I want to print 1 to 10 values. I want to print 1 to 10 values. So simply this for loop says that one, for I equal to 1, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus. What it means? I want to print 1 to 10 values. Here there is a one condition. If I equal to 5, okay, na? When I reaches 5, continue. What it means? So simply in break what happened? If I equal to 5, that means when I reaches 5, it break the for loop. That means it stopped the execution. But here continue what happened? When our I value reaches 5, that only break that 5 only. That only break the 5 and remaining statements continue. Here the output may be like this: 1 printed, 2 printed, 3 printed, 4 also printed. When I equal to 5, that means 5 not printed, 6 printed, 7 printed, 8 also printed, 9 and 10 also printed. So what happened here? Only 5 value is not printed. If I equal to 5, that means when I value reaches 5, it break that particular I equal to 5, nothing but condition, that only break that particular I equal to 5. The remaining values it can print. Okay, now the remaining values are print. Okay, now so let me execute this program. Okay, now this program name is cont.c, quant c. Okay, now execute this one. Open our Turbo C. Yes. Okay. So wait 2 to 3 seconds until our Turbo C open. Yes, it is open. Now, what is our program? cont.c. Yes, this is my program. Okay, now it type. So yes, what happened here? I want to print 1 to 10 numbers. Okay, here there is a condition. I equal to 5. If I equal to 5, continue. What it means? Okay, na? When our I value is reaches 5, when our Y value is reached 5, it break only that particular 5 value and print remaining value until our loop, that is 10 value. So 1 to 10 values are printed, but 5 is not printed. Why? Because this is a condition. Now, let me execute. Yes, compile. Now, execute. What happened here? Check this output. 1, 2, 3, 4 printed, but 5 is not there. 5 is not there. Why? Because if I equal to 5, continue. So if I equal to 5, that means only that 5 value is breaked and remaining values are printed. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is nothing but continue. So simply what it means? So break and continue statements are same, but there is a difference. Break statement break the loop when our condition reach. Here continue statement also break only that particular condition value and continue remaining values. This is about our break and continue. Okay, and this is very important topic, and this is very important topic. Break and continues are very useful in loops. Okay, now so this is about our break and continue statements. Okay, now next one is infinite loops. Infinite loops. Okay, now yes, what is the meaning of infinite loops? The name itself consists of infinite. Infinite means there is no finite. Finite means, for example, 10 finite, 20 finite, 30 finite, 1 lakh finite, okay, na? 1 crore finite. Okay, na? Infinity is nothing but infinity. Infinity. What is the value of infinity? We can't say. What is the meaning of infinity? We can't say. Okay, na? So simply, infinite loops. What the meaning of infinite loops? Okay, na? Infinite loops are simply a loops. Infinite loops are a simple loops. Okay, na? That repeated forever without stopping. Without stopping. This is the meaning of infinite loop. So simply, infinite loops are a simple loops that repeat forever. That repeat forever without stopping. That means in every loop. Yes, what is the meaning of loop? What is the meaning of loop? Here, loop is nothing but repeat a statement many times. It depends upon the condition. For example, 10 times, 20 times, 1 lakh times, 1 crore times. This is nothing but simple loops. Right? So here, infinite loops are nothing but simply loops. But here, there is no end value. There is no end value. So if there is no end value, what it means? It executing continuously. It executing continuously. That is endless. Simply the endless loops are nothing but infinite loops. Simply we can say endless loops are nothing but infinite loops. Start is there, but there is no ending. Starting is there, but there is no ending. That means when these infinite loops occur in our program is executing continuously. There is no stops. There is no stops. There is no endless. Okay, na? There is no stoppings. This is nothing but infinite loops. Simply, here infinite loops are loops. The endless loops are nothing but infinite loops. Okay, na? That means it execute the statements n number of times. N number of times and also continuing. Okay, na? N number of times. It execute a statement n number of times and also it is not endless and also it is forever, forever executing without stopping. Okay, now this is about our infinite loops. These infinite loops also called as indefinite. Okay, na? Indefinite loops. Okay, na? Indefinite loops. Infinite loops also called as indefinite loops. Okay, na? So whenever this infinite loop occur in our program, okay, na? This may cause one type of error. Simply, these infinite loops are nothing but one type of error. Which type of error? This is not syntax error. This is a logical error only. Generally, these infinite loops occur in our program. We may call as this is a logical error. We may correct this. We must correct this error. Else, our program executing continuously. Generally, this type of infinite loops may occur wrong variable is incremented. Generally, this type of infinite loop may occur how wrong variable is incremented. So let us check. Okay, this is our program. Here there are two variables are declared, that is I comma j. Clear screen. Okay, for I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Generally here I plus plus means I want to print I value 1 to 5. I want to print I value 1 to 5. But here mistakenly I type I equal to 0, I less than 5, J plus plus. In the place of I plus plus, I mistakenly type J plus plus. What here occurred? So I print I value. I printed I value. Now whenever this program executes, what happened? This program goes infinite loop. This program goes infinite loop. Why? For example, I value is 0. Starting value is 0. Ending value is 5. Okay, I value, ending value is 5. But there is no ending value for J. But there is no ending value for J. That means That means j is never stop. J value is incremented continuously. J value is incremented continuously. Okay, na? There is no stop. There is no ending value. J plus plus. But how, when our j is stopped, that is not declared here. That means j is continuously incremented. Okay, na? That is endless. So simply here j value is continuously incremented. I value is just printed. I value is printed continuously, endless. So this is the simple example of infinite loop. Let us execute this one. Okay, na? So my program name is infi. Okay, infi.c. Now execute this one. Where is that search? Okay, open infi. Where is that? Yes, infi.c. This is my simple program. The demanded infinite loop. Okay, na? So here there are two variables are declared, I comma j, clear screen for I equal to 0. So I value starts from 0. Okay, na? End value is 5. Okay, na? So 1 to 0 to 5 values I want to print. But here, mistakenly, in the place of I, j is printed. J plus plus. That means j value, when j value is stated, that is not initialized. When j value is stopped, that is not also initialized. So j is under infinite loop. That means simply, this is the simple program to demonstrate infinite. So compile it. Yes, I compiled. Okay, na? So see this result. See this result. So this is continuously printing. This is continuously printing. Okay, na? Check here. This is continuously printing, not stopping. Any key, press any key, never stop. It is printing continuously. Okay, na? So 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Okay, na? 1 day, 2 day. Okay, na? This is printing continuously. Okay, na? How this is stopped? Just press end. Okay, na? So control break ending. Whenever you press control break, then our program is stopped. Okay, na? So whenever our memory is full, then automatically stop our RAM. Okay, na? Our RAM is full, then automatically stop. Or we can stop with the help of our control plus break keys. Okay, na? So this is nothing but infinite loop. Now I am breaking. Yes, breaking. Okay, na? So this is nothing but, for example, here I am initializing I. What happened? In the place of j, I am initializing I. What happened? So this is not infinite loop. Okay, na? Yes. Now print this one, I plus plus. Yes, I plus plus. So compile this one. I compiled. Now execute this one. Now only 0 to 4 printed. This will never execute. Okay, na? So this is nothing. This is not infinite loop. This is a finite loop. Okay, na? But in the place of I replaced with j. So this is infinite loop. Okay, this is infinite loop. Yes, check it. Okay, na? So this is a logical error. This is a logical error. This is nothing but infinite loops. Okay, na? Yes. Time is already completed. Okay, na? So ready for next class. Thank you.